in yonder wood and cordially invites you all to join his party. Furthermore, he bids me to tell you that should the hunt be a good one, then a great ball be held at the Castle Glamorous this very evening so that all may celebrate with him.
Sorry, but you can't stay here. We've got respectable people coming to see this show. They pay good money for them seats. I know it might be cold outside.
Psst.
As I was saying.
Psst. Oi, come here.
What? Hang on. Don't go away. Not till I come back, anyway.
Stop messing about.
It's not me, it's this lot. We've got respectable people coming tonight. What, them? They're the audience?
Who's?
Sorry, ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls. Just a slight technical hitch. All sorted now. Are you sure?
Get on with it!
Fair enough. Let me welcome you all to our show. Before we proceed, the management would like me to point out a few safety features. Firstly, should any of you accidentally get a glimpse of the Ugly Sisters without their makeup on, we will be handing out sick bags. Of course, should you find it easier to do, you can always pop them over your heads to block out the view, although please make sure you haven't used them first. Secondly, should any of you find yourselves gasping for breath after laughing at all the hilarious jokes, simply take the bags, hold them in front of your faces and take a few deep breaths to calm yourself down. Although, once again, never mind. Let's get on with the show. My name is Buttons. That's B-U-T-T-O-N-S. It's easy to remember, kids, because it's snot tub backwards. Well, I work for Baron Hardup at Stonybroke Mansion. Stonybroke Mansion. They couldn't have given it a better name. Nobody's got any money, not even the Baron. I haven't had any wages for 10 years. And I have to do all the work. Gardening, cooking, cleaning, washing, and all the ironing. Anyway, right now I've got to find Cinderella to tell her the good news about her dad. Oh, I didn't tell you, did I? Well, Cinders is Baron Hardup's daughter, and she's ever so smashing. I think she's the prettiest girl in the whole world, and you won't tell anyone, will you? But I'm in love with her. Anyway, right now I've got to deliver this message to Cinders. It says they're going to let her dad come home today. He's going to be free. Oh, she's an half going to be pleased when she hears that. She cried and cried when he had to go in there. She couldn't even visit him without a pass, and she was terrified of all those great big guard dogs. There wasn't much better for her around here. Well, you know what some folk can be like, all those nasty remarks. Still, he's only got himself to blame. He would go to centre parks for his holidays. Oh, well, I better carry on looking. But if you happen to see Cinders, you will tell her I'm looking for her, won't you? Just say Buttons wants you and... Aye, aye. Excuse me?
Yes?
I don't suppose you've seen Cinders, have you?
I beg your pardon?
Cinders.
Not today, thank you.
Oh, there's one in every village, isn't there? Oi, fancy pants. I'm not selling Cinders, I'm looking for Cinders.
Then I suggest you try searching through the local dustbins.
Not Ashes Cinders. Cinders from the mansion. Cinderella Cinders. Baron Hardup's daughter.
Oh, I'm terribly sorry. I thought, please forgive me.
Oh, that's all right. You can't help being stupid. So, have you seen her?
Don't think so. I'm sorry, I'm a stranger to these parts. I wouldn't know, even if I had.
Oh, you would do. She's the most beautiful girl in the whole world. One day, as soon as I'm rich enough, I'm going to marry her.
Oh, waiting for your ship to come in, are you?
Not half. Trouble is, I've been waiting so long the blooming pier's starting to collapse. So you haven't seen her then?
I don't think so. I only came to Bluntisham to deliver a message from the royal party.
Well, that's funny, because I've got a message for Cinders. My dad's coming home from Centre Parks today, and he says he's got a big surprise for her.
How nice. Then he'll be just in time for the ball, if all goes well.
A ball? At a palace?
Yes, this very night. I'll be around later with the tickets.
Yeah, can I come as well?
But of course, the prince will invite everyone.
Oh, smashing. I'll see you later then.
And I'd better be getting back to the hunt. The prince will wonder where earth I am.
What a wonderful day it is today. Not a cloud in the sky. And the first day of spring. I don't mind being poor at all on a day like this. Oh, if only Daddy were here.
Cinderella! Cinderella! I'm home! Cinders!
Daddy!
Oh, I've missed you so very much. It's good to be home again.
And I've missed you, Daddy. Did you have a nice time?
Oh, marvellous. Simply marvellous. I won the Nobbiest New Year's competition 2 weeks running. And guess what else?
What?
Ah, troubles are over. From now on, we'll have money to burn.
You mean you won the lottery?
No, no. Something much better than that. I've got the most wonderful surprise for you. I just know you're going to be thrilled. Now close your eyes. No peeking, mind.
What do you mean by keeping me waiting over there?
Oh, what is it? Save me! Save me!
What is it? What's wrong?
It's Spoke! It's Spoke! Mercy!
What is it, Medusa, my pet? What's wrong?
That monster!
That's my little step. No, that's my little daughter.
Daughter?
Hmm. Cinderella.
Oh. What's wrong with her, Daddy? Why is she fainted?
I must have been the shock, my dear. I don't think you realised how grown up you were.
She called me a monster. Who is she?
She's your new surprise.
What?
Well, I decided to get married again. She's your new stepmother.
Oh, no.
Well, she has money, my sweet. And you know how poor we are. And the broker's men are coming today to throw us out of the mansion. Unless we pay our debts.
Well, if you think you're using my money, you've got another thing coming. Now that I'm mistress of Stonybrook Mansion, there are going to be a few changes around here. And to start off with, that can sleep in the kitchen.
Sleep in the kitchen? She most certainly isn't. Why should she?
Because with a face like hers, if ever we have burglars, she'll frighten them away. Now get inside that house, you lazy little toad. And clean up the bedrooms for my two lovely daughters, Asphyxia and Euthanasia.
Daughters? I didn't know you had any daughters.
Well, you know now. So you better get cracking and do as I say, or you'll never see a penny of my money. Now I'm off to look around the rest of this crumbling old ruin.
Oh, Daddy, she's awful.
Oh, I'm sorry. I was only trying to do what I thought was best. Looks like I was wrong after all.
Your reflection in the shop window. I wonder where Mumsy's got to.
Who cares? She's probably knocking back the gin in the White Swan by now. Drunken old cat.
Well, dear, there's one thing to be said for living in a flea pit like this. I shall be the most attractive young thing for miles around.
You mean I will, don't you, ducky?
You? Listen, prune features. Once the boy's got an eyeful of this figure, you won't stand a chance. I should just give them one of my famous come-hither looks, like this.
And they'll run for their lives.
I'll pucker up my lips, like this.
And they'll hold their stomachs, like this.
Careful, darling, or I'll fill your face for you. It has been said that my face is the exact image of Helen of Troy's.
3,000 years after they buried
and
her.
And her face launched 1,000 ships!
I'm not surprised. If she'd a clock half as ugly as yours is, the bidden launch would escape from the sight of it.
Whew. You've some need to talk, you grotty-looking old rat bag. I've a good mind to slap you right in the middle of those fat, flabby chops.
You know what your trouble is, don't you, dearie? You're scared of my beauty.
Beauty? If I had a face like yours, I'd put it on a brick, put it on a wall, brick and throw a wall at it.
If I had a face like yours, I'd put it on a wall and throw a brick at it.
Would you? Yes. Well, let me tell you, slug features, that I've had songs written about my beauty.
Oh, yes, I know. I've heard one of them. The hippopotamus song. Mud.
Oh!
Oh!
Struth!
A man! He's mine!
No, he's not. He's mine. I saw him first.
Let go, you foul-faced cat!
It's mine, I tell you.
Take that!
Oh!
I'd better find the zoo and tell him to have escaped.
What is it, my poppets? What's happening?
She hit me!
No, I didn't. It was him!
It was me?
There you are, Mama. He admits it. The brute!
How dare you attack my little euthanasia?
I never touched you, ugly old faggot, did I, kid? No! See?
Yes, you do, you pint-sized little... What's that?
Is it real?
This is your little stepsister, Cinderella.
Stepsister? That scruffy-looking object, my stepsister? Oh, it can't be true. Tell me it's not true.
Oh, I feel faint. I don't believe it. How can somebody as lovely as me have a dreadful-looking thing like that for a stepsister?
I know. She's just too ghastly for words, my sweets. But don't worry yourselves. I'll make quite sure she keeps her ugly face hidden whenever we have visitors. We can always lock her in the cellar!
Stop picking on Cinders, you ugly old witches. She's worth 100 of you lot.
How dare you speak to us like that? Leave the mansion at once. You're fired.
Oh, please don't send Buttons away. He's the only friend I've got.
Oh, please don't send Buttons away. He's the only friend I've got. And I've got news for you, ducky. You just lost him.
Do something, Daddy.
Of course I will. Now, just you not look
you
here.
And you can shut your cake hole. I'm giving the orders round here. Remember?
Oh, please let Buttons stay.
Don't worry, Cinders. I'll soon find another job.
Ignore him, my angels. It's time we were getting the things inside the mansion.
Things? What things?
Why, just some things we've been buying in the town, Daddy dear.
Bring it in, boys.
Don't worry, Popsy, we've got something for you too.
Of course we have. The bill. Oh, no. Oh, don't say that, Cinders. What would I do if your Wendy's died? Anyway, if you did, you wouldn't be able to go to the ball tonight, would you?
A ball? Tonight? But where?
Ah, that's got you interested, hasn't it? It's at Castle Glamorous, and everybody in the village has been invited.
Oh, I can't believe it. How did you find out?
Oh, some fancy-looking fellow wearing lipstick, high heels and no trousers told me. And the best bit, it's all free. Anybody can go. He's going to bring the tickets round later.
Oh, Buttons, that's marvellous.
That's better, you're laughing again.
Thanks to you. Oh, I must go and tell Daddy. I love you, Buttons.
She loves me. Did you hear that, kids? She loves me.
I've told every little star just how sweet I think you are. Why haven't I told you? I've told ripples in a brook, made my heart an open book. Why haven't I told you? Friends ask me, am I in love? confess. If I don't, they guess. Maybe you may know it too. Oh, my darling, if you do, why haven't you told me?
Here we are then, Mr. Tongs. Stony Broke Mansion. In you go.
Right you are, Mr. Runner.
Wait a minute, what do you mean, in I go? What are you going to do?
Well, I'm going to stand out here and count the things as you throw them out, aren't I?
All right. I hadn't thought of that. I'll go right in then.
You do that. I thought I'd want you to go in there and start throwing things out.
Well, yes, you did, but I was...
Never mind the butts. Get into that building and start earning your wages.
It's all right for you.
Why are you still messing around? Get in there, throw some things out, earn some wages.
Look, why don't you go in there and get the things? I'll stay out here and
get to the finish quicker.
Right. Watch this. What? Now wait a minute, Emma.
Yes.
Is everything all right?
Why shouldn't it be?
I mean. Didn't anything happen when you were in there?
Like what?
Well, like someone interfering with your right of way.
What are you talking about?
Oh, it doesn't matter. I'll get the next chair.
Better be to retreat like the old battle axe says.
Old battle axe? How dare you! I'll have you know that I happen to be a professional model.
Model? For what? Madame Tussauds House of Horrors?
Oh! Asphyxia! Euthanasia!
What is it? Oh, it isn't it?
It is!
Laurel and Hardy! Well, what do they want, Margaret?
I'll tell you what we want. We want some red money, and if we don't get it, we propose...
Oh, it's
help! Oh, they're shy. Our beauty's not up for six.
We want some red money. That's all, just red money. And if we don't get it, we've got strict orders...
Very strict
orders to take you...
Oh, thank you, help! That's what I like in the spinet! Awful!
Medusa, my love.
And what do you want, sheep's head?
I've heard the prince is hunting in the woods today. And if the hunt is a good one, he'll be throwing a ball at the castle tonight.
And what's so exciting about that? A grown man throwing a ball at a castle. What if he breaks something?
No, my love, you misunderstand. A ball dance. Everyone in the kingdom's going to be there.
A dance? I must tell my daughters at once. This is the perfect opportunity for them to trap some poor fellow into proposing to them. And I mean to find themselves a husband.
Yes, only if the hunt is a good one, remember.
Oh, it will be. Four Dewhursts at once and order a couple of 1,000 pheasants and 200 rabbits to be dumped in the woods. We've got to have this dance if it's the last thing we do. No, hurry, hurry. Asphyxia! Euthanasia!
Toosome been bothering you again?
Oh, Buttons, I feel so miserable.
Oh, come on, Cinders, cheer up. You're not usually like this. Anything I can do to help?
No, just leave me alone for a while. I'll get over it.
Look, you want me to go away?
Please.
Oh. Cinders?
Well, we'll go away if you really want me to, but you don't, do you? Not honestly.
No, Buttons, of course I don't.
So what's the matter? Come on, you can tell me.
They won't let me go to the ball tonight. My new stepmother and stepsisters.
Well, they can't stop you.
Old Fancy Pants said anyone can go, even me. Now come on, blow your nose and cheer up.
But you don't understand, Buttons. My stepmother says I've got to do the laundry.
Well, don't you worry, Cinders. You'll go to the ball, all right? I'll stay home and do the washing.
You will? No, it wouldn't be fair.
I don't mind, honest, I don't. I can't dance anyway.
But what about a ticket? I haven't got one.
Oh, simple. You can have mine. I mean, I shan't be needing it, will I?
Oh, Buttons, I love you.
She said it again.
Now, I better finish gathering sticks or I'll never be ready in time.
Oh, hang on, Cinders, I'll lend you a hand.
Up and down like a kangaroo. Nardini. Looks like we shall be having our ball after all. Hunting's been extraordinarily good. 2,000 pheasants and a couple of hundred rabbits in a matter of only half an hour. It really is amazing. There's one thing that puzzles me, though.
Sire?
They all appear to be price marked.
Good heavens!
Oh, Dandini, you old rogue. I suppose this is your doing.
I assure you.
I've never known anyone go to such lengths just for a ball. I suppose they're all charged to me.
But I know nothing about it, Your Highness.
Well, then where did they come from?
I haven't the faintest idea.
Oh, well, I've never been one to look a gift horse in the mouth. Here, take them back to the castle and have the cooks prepare them for this evening.
Your Highness looks tired. Would you care to rest a while under shade of yonder tree?
Oh, you don't know how much. The responsibilities of a prince are like a millstone round one's neck.
I wouldn't mind having a millstone like that round mine. The fun I would have in your place.
Do you think so?
I certainly do.
Well, I have to say, Dandini, I envy you. If I were in your shoes for a while and as free as the wind, I'd be having a fine old time with all those village girls of yours.
Then why not?
Why not what?
Oh, nothing. Just a sudden thought.
Well, tell me.
Why don't we change places? You could be Dandini and I could be His Royal Highness, Prince Charming.
Dandini, we couldn't. Could we?
We could give it a try.
Then we shall. Off with your hat. Voila! How do I look, Dandini?
I beg your pardon. Prince Charming to you, Dandini.
I'm so sorry. Your Highness.
Look, it's the Prince. Quick, introduce me.
What should I say, my sweet?
This is my wife, you idiot.
This is my wife, you idiot.
Oh, no!
So, this is my wife, you fool.
And who are you? Insolent fellow.
Baron Hardup of Stonybrook Mansion, sire.
And I am his gracious wife, the Baroness Medusa Hardup.
What do you want?
We've come to join the hunt, Your Highness. I'm sorry, madam, you're too late. The hunt's over. Everyone's gone back to the castle to prepare for the ball.
And the prince, I mean I, feel rather tired. So if you'll excuse us.
Yes, of course, at once. No trouble.
Tell him! Tell him!
Tell him what?
About my daughters!
They've done nothing wrong to you.
Your principalship, yes? I'd like to introduce you to my two lovely daughters, Asphyxia and Euthanasia.
Well, I'm sure we'll meet them at the ball tonight. Please don't bother them now.
Oh, no bother, no bother, Your Highness. I'll just give them a little call. Asphyxia! Euthanasia!
Oh, it's him! Prince Charming!
He's mine!
Oh, you make one move in his direction, Squint Eyes, and I'll knock your teeth down your throats.
One more word from you, fish face, and I'll sling yours in the river.
Oh, girls, girls! Oh. Such high spirits! Now come along and say hello to Princey!
Oh, hello, Chuck. I'm Asphyxia. But you can call me Aspy.
And I'm Euthanasia, but you can call me all the time.
Pleased to meet you, I'm sure.
I'm not seen that without my arse.
He's just thinking of jokes for the ball tonight.
He should try looking in a mirror.
I beg your pardon.
You heard.
How much we've enjoyed meeting Your Highness. Oh, how much we're looking forward to the ball tonight. In fact, we were wondering if
you might like a little entertainment.
Entertainment?
Yes. Asphyxia can sing like a bird.
A crow.
A euthanasia can dance like a feather.
An oil slick.
I should take care of...
I know that we're only too pleased to perform for you this evening.
Oh, please, no. No, it's okay.
Come along, darlings. Show the prince your talents.
Tiptoe
through the tulips, through the tulips. That is where I'll be. And tiptoe through the tulips.
Thank you. We'll get back to you.
Weren't they wonderful? Yeah,
especially when they stopped.
I must admit, I've never heard anything like it before.
That's because I've got a voice like an angel's.
Yes, it's like nothing on earth.
Dandini, your highness, isn't it time we were getting back to the castle?
Oh, yes, of course. Please excuse us.
Of course.
Bye. Oh, not goodbye, sweetie pie. An hour reservoir.
We've done it!
We've done what?
Made a hit with the prince, you dolt!
Oh, well, I know I did. Did you see that look he gave me? It was love at first sight.
More like indigestion to me.
And nobody's asking you, fish face. When I am the prince's bride, the first thing I shall do is to get rid of you.
The only bride you'll ever be is the bride of Frankenstein.
You open that bran masher of yours once more, and I shall tear that greasy blonde hair out by its dirty black roots.
Ooh. Girls, there's no need to fight over him.
It's all right for you. You managed to trip yourself a man.
With what?
Loosely speaking. If we're not careful, we're going to end up on the shelf.
Nonsense. When we get to the ball tonight, there will be plenty of men to choose from. I can see it all now. The tables loaded with food. The chandeliers loaded with candles. The men loaded with money.
Yes, and you three loaded with gin.
What?
Excuse me, my child.
Oh, you startled me.
I'm sorry. Please, could you help me gather a few sticks for my fire? These old bones of mine are not as supple as they used to be.
Here, take mine. I can easily gather more.
No, I couldn't possibly.
Of course you could. Please. Now hurry home.
Thank you, my child. You're very kind to an old man, and shall be rewarded for this unselfish act.
I don't want a reward. I'm only too pleased to be able to help.
Nevertheless, you shall have your reward just the same. When the time comes that you feel the saddest, call on me, and I shall come to your aid.
Well, it's very kind of you, but what can you do to help me?
We shall see.
What a strange old man. And now I better finish and start gathering more sticks. Oh.
Must have left it somewhere around here. Oh, you found it.
Yours?
Yes. I had to leave in rather a hurry a few moments ago. Thank you for rescuing it. Do I know you from somewhere?
I don't think so, sir. I'm only a girl from the village.
Strange. I seem to know your face.
Perhaps it's my father, you know, Baron Hardup.
Baron Hardup? The Stony Brook Mansion? I don't believe it!
Do you know Daddy then?
I'll say I do. You mean to say that someone as beautiful as you is the sister of those ugly looking... Oh, I'm so sorry, I shouldn't have said that, should I? Please forgive me.
Of course. It's not their fault they're like that, I suppose. But as a matter of fact, they're my stepsisters, not my real ones. My mother died when I was very small, and I'm an only child.
And what's your name?
Cinderella. What's yours?
I am Prince Charming. Valet Dandini.
Dandini. What a lovely name.
Not as nice as Prince Charming, though, is it?
Oh, yes, it is. To me.
Oh, I forgot. You haven't met the prince, have you? Now, there's a fine figure of a man.
Well, if he's as handsome as you are, then he must be.
Oh, he's far handsomer than I. But you wait and see till you see him at the ball this evening. You are coming to the ball, aren't you?
Oh, yes.
Then you must promise you will dance with no one but me.
What if the prince should
have? Oh, don't worry about the prince. He'll do anything I tell him.
I must be dreaming.
Of course. That's where I've seen you before. In my dreams.
Cinders. Oh, there you are. Look, I've gathered all these sticks for you.
Here, who's this thing?
This is Dandini Buttons. He's the prince's squire.
Prince's choir? Let's hear him sing something then.
No, I can't sing.
Oh, Buttons, I'm going to dance every dance with him at the ball tonight.
Oh, you are you? What am I supposed to do then?
But you said you'd stay home and do the laundry for me.
Oh, yeah, I know. I'm not going to if you're going to dance all night with him.
Well, why?
And I shan't give him a ticket to go with either.
Buttons!
Oh, don't worry, Cinderella. I've got plenty here. Here. And now I really must be going. But don't forget, I'll be waiting for you at the ball tonight. Farewell.
I'm ashamed of you.
Don't care.
You're very rude to Dandini.
Don't care.
Buttons, you're jealous.
Well?
There's no need to be jealous, Buttons. I still like you too.
You said you loved me.
And I do, as a brother.
Look.
Would you please for me, Buttons? Just a little?
No.
Buttons? Well, I suppose I'd better be getting back to the mansion.
Oh, that's what I came to tell you. That new stepmother of yours is out looking for you.
What? Oh dear, I better hurry then. Bye, Buttons, and please cheer up.
Won't tell you the good news now. Got me old job back. She doesn't care, does she? All she's interested in is that rotten old Dandini. What's he got that I haven't? I'm better than that swanky old tailor's dummy any day, ain't I, folks?
No.
Yeah, of course I am. Now she's got him, she doesn't want to know about me anymore. She wouldn't care if I went away and never came back again.
You're wrong, Dandini. Cinderella cares a great deal for you, but it's written that she must love another.
Blimey, it's the godfather.
That's right. I'm Cinderella's fairy godfather. I come to ask a great favor of you.
Hey?
I need you to look out for Cinderella. Take special care of her. Pretty soon, she's going to be needing your friendship more than anything else in the whole wide world.
What? Even more than that Dandini fella?
Much more, Buttini. Much, much more. You don't look out for her, she's going to be more unhappy than she's ever been in her whole life.
Why? What's going to happen to her?
A wicked stepmother and her two stepsisters? They're going to do everything in their power to drive her away from home and family and the ones she loves. Only you're going to be able to stop them.
Me? What about you? If you're a fairy godfather, why can't you stop them?
Hey, a little respect over here. I can't be around all the time. I got to be out of town sometimes. I need you to, look out for things while I'm not here, you know? Be my right-hand guy. You do that for me, Buttini?
What? That sort of deputy sheriff?
A lesser deputy sheriff, more a good fella.
Oh. Yeah. Can I have a badge? You know, a star to stick on my jacket?
We don't really go in for stars in my line of work, Buttini. Hey. Why don't you take a cell phone? There you go.
Oh, brill.
Hey, don't play with that. It's expensive. All right, now look out for things while I'm gone, all right? But, if you get in trouble, give me a call. I'll come help you out.
Well, I know where to find you.
No, it's easy. Just page me.
Oh. Here, hang on. Do I get frequent use of this help?
Tongs. Have we lost them?
Oh, I think so. That was a close shave.
Oh, I thought we'd had it for a minute there. Oh, I've never run so fast in all my life.
Yeah. But did you see the faces on them? Did you see the face on that fat one?
If I had a face like that, I'd hire someone to steal it.
If I had a face like the other one, yeah. I'd hire myself out at Halloween parties. Can't be the face she was born with. Must be a retread.
Yeah. But, well, what are we going to do now? We can't go back there when they're still there.
I've got it. What we'll do is wait till that ball at the castle begins tonight.
Yeah.
Then we'll sneak into the mansion and grab all the furniture. Easy.
Brilliant. Sneaking.
Correct.
Brilliant.
Then all we got to do is sell that furniture. Then we can go on that holiday we've been promising ourselves for the past 5 years. Oh.
2 weeks in Paris. Those wonderful girls.
Wonderful girls, yes. Paris, no. We are not going to Paris. I've told you this before. We are going to Rome.
Rome? What's in Rome?
In Rome, there are ruins. Old, magnificent ruins.
Ruins.
You fool!
Now, don't try to fight this. This thing is bigger than both of us.
What thing?
Her mouth. Ooh.
Now, listen, foul face. For the last time, I do not have a big mouth.
Darling, the only mouth I know that's bigger than yours is the mouth of the Amazon River.
Is that so?
Yes, your mouth is so big you have to keep your false teeth in the spare room.
That is a wicked lie. I keep them in a bucket beside the bed. And anyway, you have some need to talk. Your mouth is so big, you had to have safety rails fitted to stop potholes from falling in.
Why, you grotty-looking creep! Oh, they've gone.
Quick, after them!
Oh, let them go.
You crackers, they're men!
You can get them at the ball tonight.
Oh, well, if that's the way you feel, you can have the pair of them. I shall be too busy with the prince to bother with those drips.
You with the prince? Don't make me laugh. By the time tonight is over, I shall be the new princess. And you'll be back where you belong, in the sewers.
Is that so? Well, let me tell you, the few soft words breathed in the right direction, and the prince will be lying at my feet.
I shouldn't be at all surprised. Your breath will knock him unconscious. Oh. Anyway, I'm not standing here arguing with you. I'm off to get myself pretty. Anyhow, my prince awaits me.
Oh, well, in that case, I'd better pop down to the chemist to buy him a little present. Hadn't I?
What sort of present?
Well, dear, if he's going to be seeing you in full lighting, he'll be in urgent need of what I'm going to buy him.
What is it?
A case of smelling salt and a stomach pump.
Why, you...
Escaped, haven't we?
Yeah, but I haven't gone to that ball tonight.
Oh.
I haven't got a thing to wear. Can't buy anything, so I haven't got any money.
Oh, if you're broke, I can lend you some money.
Yeah. Very good of you.
Oh, you know, they always want to help a friend. Let's see. Yes, I can lend you £3.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
Oh, wait a minute. I've lent you all the money I have. I don't have any left now.
I'll tell you what, I'll lend you £1.
£1? Thank you very much.
No problem. So, I owe you £2.
That's right.
And you owe me £1.
Well,
there's the
yes.
£2 that I owe you.
Right.
And this is £1 that you owe me. Right. So I'll see you later.
Wait, what? Hang on.
What?
Can't really follow this.
Can't see it.
Well, no.
I tell you what.
Yeah?
This will sort it out. What we'll do, we'll change places.
Okay.
You pretend to be me. You will be lending me the £3, and I will be you at that point, whilst you're being me, receiving the £3 from you, which will be me at that point.
That's simple.
It's simple. Okay. Simple, I promise you. Okay.
There you go.
Ready?
Don't rush me. I don't remember.
Lend me £3, please.
That's exactly what I said. Right, but you said it because you're being... Yeah, there's the £3. Right. And I'm going to lend you them all. There you go.
£3, right. Oh, and I lend you £1.
Mm-hmm. Yeah. That's what I said, yeah. But you said it, but you're being me, so yeah.
Right.
So, I owe you £1.
Right.
And you owe me £2. See, simple, all sorted.
Yes. Still don't really see this, you know. I mean, I started with £3.
Yes.
And then I had £2 and...
Granted.
And now I've got £1.
I tell you what, I've got it this time. Be completely simple. Foolproof, I promise you.
Yeah?
What we'll do is we'll change places.
Right.
And we'll change hats.
Well, why didn't we do that in the first place?
I don't know. So, yeah, okay.
Right. Should we stand?
Yep.
You're right. Okay.
Wasn't I here first time? I don't.
What?
You go over there.
That's right.
You're being me.
That's right.
But you are. Yeah, okay. You ready?
I'm ready. Lend me £3, please.
Certainly. One, two, three.
There we go.
Now, that means you owe me £3, doesn't it?
Well, yeah.
Never mind her tarred string, fetch me my gown.
Hair!
Gown!
Hair!
Gown!
Yes, yes, yes.
What's the matter with you?
I don't know which to do first.
Fetch my gown!
Do my hair!
Oh, you're hurting me!
I will hurt you in a minute, you lazy little good-for-nothing creep! Now, do as you're told!
The servants
these days...
I'm not your servant. If you don't stop shouting, I won't help either of you.
Ooh! Got a cheeky little one here, have we? Well, we know how to treat her sort, don't we, sister dear?
We certainly do. Did you see the way she just tried to attack me?
Trying to kick me, eh?
And now she's trying to claw me. Now fetch my hairbrush and make it snappy. I'm going to make myself look beautiful for the prince. Now stop that snivelling and do it at once while I put a new face on.
Thank goodness for that. Thought you were going to wear that rotten old one for the rest of your life.
Who said that?
She did.
No.
Right. She did. I know how to say it with these very lips.
Right. I'll soon fix her. Come here.
Oh, please. I didn't say anything.
Yes, she did, didn't she? Oh, yes, she did.
Oh, yes, she did.
Oh, yes, she did.
She did?
Did
she say it?
Glass eyed toad!
I'll beat you to death with your own false eyelashes!
Mummy! Mummy!
What is it? What's the matter?
It's that nasty little bother causer. She's been calling my sweet little sister nasty names, and I'm getting the blame from that rotten lot out there!
Well, what else can you expect from Bluntisham Cum Corn residents? She's at it already, is she? I knew she was a bother causer the moment I first set eyes on her. Well, I'll fix her. Get upstairs at once and change all the bedding. Then you can scrub the floors until they shine. Wash the dishes, iron the curtains, and fetch in the coal. Then you can polish all the furniture, shine the brasses, dust the portraits, wash the windows, sweep the drive, clean out all the gutters, pick up all the leaves off the lawn, weed the garden, bake the bread, clean the kitchen, and when you've done all that, you can clean out the stable.
But I'm going to the ball.
Oh, my hand slipped. I'm so
to be ashamed of yourself stopping her from going to the ball.
Asphyxia, my love. Do you feel all right?
Of course I feel all right. It's just that I can't stand spiteful people. I'll tell you what. I'm thinking of letting her go to the ball after all.
But you couldn't. You just couldn't.
Oh, I think I could. Shall I let her go to the ball, folks? Shall I?
Yes!
And shall I lend her one of my beautiful frocks to wear to go in?
Yes!
And you, Cinderella dear, how would you like to come to the ball with me and leave old Frog Features there at home on her own and see how she likes it?
Oh, yes, Asphyxia, I would.
I thought so. You want to go to that ball more than anything else in the world, don't you?
Oh, yes.
Well, that's exactly why you're not going, you cross.
Come along, girls. Let's go and get ready.
Cinders, Cinders.
Oh, don't cry, my love.
What's the matter?
Oh, Daddy, I wanted to go to the ball tonight, but they won't let me.
Of course you can go to the ball. It's nothing to do with them.
Now, you go and get yourself into a pretty dress, and I'll take you to the ball myself.
Oh, Daddy!
I'll show them who's boss around here.
Oh? And who is... who is the boss?
You are my precious.
So what makes you think you've got the right to stand there and say who goes to the ball and who doesn't?
Because I've got the tickets, that's why. They've just come through the door.
Hand them over.
Well, does Cinderella go with us to the ball or not?
Of course she doesn't.
Right. Well, that leaves three.
But there are four of us.
Well, there were four of us. Now, does Cinders go or do I tear up another?
I suppose so. Now give me the tickets. But there are only two here. I need three.
Oh no, this one's for me. You can fight it out amongst you who gets the two you've got.
And what about your precious Cinderella? Where's her ticket coming from?
Well, in that case, I'll have one of those back and your two can stay at home.
Oh no, if they can't have it, then nobody can.
Well, that leaves two.
One for you and one for me.
No, no, no. One for me and one for Cinderella.
I'll die first.
You silly old faggot. Now look what you've done.
It's your fault. You drove me to it.
There's only one place I'd like to drive you to, and that's to the edge of that cliff.
Oh!
Oh, how I'd wish I'd never married you. Women. One ticket. What am I supposed to do with that?
Yeah, home. Anybody home?
What are you screaming at, Pipsqueak?
There's a man without.
Without what?
He says he wants an audience.
Well, give it this dozy lot.
Well, do I ask him in or don't I? He's from the castle.
The castle?
Oh, it's the prince for me!
Just show me.
Quick, I better put something on.
Oh, try a mask.
You've some need to talk. You should have been born in the Dark Ages. You look terrible in the light.
Good evening. Oh, good night.
Oh,
I was actually looking for the daughter of Baron Harder.
Oh, that's me.
The youngest daughter?
That's me.
Isn't there another one?
No, just me.
Then I seem to be misled.
Oh, you saucy old thing, you.
I'd best be going back. The ball, you know.
I shall look forward to dance every dance with you in your principality.
Yes, she'll be very light on your feet, as long as you dance on your hands. Dance with me instead.
I'm sorry, ladies. I shall be in very great demand. I'm very well known, you understand. Until tonight. I'm ready.
And where do you think you're going? Little Miss Droopy Draws.
I'm going to the ball with you. Daddy said he'd take me. Do you like the dress? Will it be all right?
Dress? Dress? I've seen better looking floorcloths. Oh, I'm sorry.
My dress!
soon even it up.
No, no, stop it.
That's no way to treat us for looking after, is it, sister dear?
The absolute ingratitude of the child. And besides, just look at that skirt. Skirts are out.
No, no, no.
Well, that's next to her, sister dear. Come along, let's get ready.
Our puppet is waiting.
Poor old cinders. I'll make them sorry for what they've just done. Fancy ruining her dress just so she can't go to the ball. If she went in rags, she'd look better than those two. Wonder where they get their dresses from, Tents R Us. Never mind, I'll have her all to myself. We'll have our own party. I've got a little bag of crisps and a bruised apple. And there's bound to be some cheese in one of the mouse traps.
Yeah.
We'll have our own party on our own.
Look at this mess. I don't know. Worth some clearing up after kids.
I hate them.
Oh, don't cry, Cinders. There'll be another ball at the palace. I'll take you there myself, honest I will.
But it's this ball I want to go to, Buttons. Dandini will be waiting for me.
Dandini? In that case, I hope you wait forever. Oh, don't cry, Cinders. I didn't mean it.
I'm so unhappy.
Well, there's no use sitting there crying about it, is there?
Nothing's impossible, I have found. For when my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, dust myself off, start all over again. Don't lose your confidence if you slip. Be grateful for a pleasant trip. And pick yourself up, dust yourself off, start all over again. Work like a soul inspired, till that one day is won. You may be sick and tired, but you'll be a man, my son. Won't you remember those famous men who had to fall to rise again? So take a deep breath, pick yourself up, start all over again. Take a deep breath, pick yourself up, start all over again.
To you.
Now let's see you keep that smile.
Well, we're off.
I thought something smelled around here.
See, this place is cleaned up by the time we get back.
Oh, good night, Cinders. I'll try to bring you back a little something.
Come along, Percival.
Right. Good night, my love. Look after her, Buns.
Well, they've gone off to the ball.
Yes.
Cinders, you sure you're all right? Cinders? Oh, come on, Cinders, say something to me. Cinders?
Go away.
Cinders?
Go away.
All right, then I will. Ta-ra, then. I'm going. I won't be coming back. I've got it! Don't go away!
Buttons! What's everyone talking about? Who's there?
Who's that, my child? The old man from the woods. You helped me out earlier today. Now I come to keep my promise to you. Tell me, my child, what is your heart's desire? Name it, and it shall be yours.
My heart's desire? Oh, to go to the ball tonight. But how can you help us do that?
Simple.
I'm your fairy godfather. This is Vito and Tito. Your good friend Bottini gave me a call earlier. Told me what was going down. Because you're kind-hearted and honest, your wish shall be granted. You shall go to the ball tonight.
But how?
That's simple. You just gotta do like I tell you.
Now, first off, I need you to... Wait a second. Vito, Tito, do me a favor. Go down to the cellar, get me a large pumpkin, 6 white mice, and a pair of lizards, okay? Go. That's great, guys. Just, I don't know, put them down there near the fireplace or something. It's a good pumpkin, Vito.
Awesome.
All right, I guess we better organize you something to wear. Vito, thank you very much. Hey, girls, you're looking very pretty tonight. All right, I need you to do me a favor. I need you to take this girl and make her the most beautiful ball gown the world ever did see. You do that for me? Thank you very much. Come on, guys. Pretty much anything you want to tonight, alright? I guess we better arrange you some kind of transportation. Coat should be good. Thank you very much, Vito. Ah,
All right, now off you go. Enjoy yourself, okay? But you gotta remember one thing. The spell's gonna end at midnight, so you gotta leave in time to get back here before then. If not, your fine clothes are gonna turn back into rags, and your coach and your footman are gonna vanish into thin air. Capiche?
Oh, yes, and thank you. Thank you a million times.
Just remember, 12 o'clock, all right?
Soon, I know I'm just going to burst.
And you're quite sure she said she was the Baron Hardart's daughter, sire? I mean, the ones I saw were like leftovers from last week's dinner.
Dandini. Well, you keep a sharp eye out for her and tell me the moment she arrives. I must pay attention to some of our other guests.
Yes, got it bad.
Baron and Baroness Hardart and their daughters. Asphyxia and euthanasia.
Sweet boy.
And Mr. Ammer and Mr. Tots.
£3 well spent.
Oh, I don't understand it. Where can she be?
Yoo-hoo, Prinny, I'm here!
Out of the way, repulsive! Whoa. Come on, Prinny, let's swing it.
Let go of me, woman! I'm afraid you've made a mistake. I am Dandini, the Prince's valet. This is His Highness.
What? Old sparrow legs? But you said in the woods that you, oh no.
I knew all the time. Come on, handsome, let's sit down and discuss our wedding
plan. Help me at once, woman. How dare you lay a hand on me.
Please, please excuse them, your washer. It's their father's bad manners coming out.
Make sure it doesn't happen again. Come, Dandini. We'll go into the other room.
Come, Dandini. We'll go into the other room. Who does he think he is? Robin Williams?
Don't upset yourself, darling. You'll realise someday that some people have no manners at all.
Oh, you can say that again.
What we've got to do now is work out some way to get him to propose to one of you. Let's go into the garden and work on a plan.
Oh dear.
wonder what they've got to.
I don't know. I bet it's something horrible.
Yeah, there's something. Why have they gone into the garden?
To frighten the bats away.
Yeah, there's certainly something brewing out there.
By the looks of those three, it'll be a cauldron.
The Princess Crystal.
Blimey.
Can't be, it's impossible.
Princess, welcome to the castle. I am Prince Charming.
Prince Charming? But I thought, Your Highness.
Allow me to take your arm.
Why, thank you.
Oh, I'm so glad you came. Until you arrived, the evening looked dull. But now your presence makes the whole castle look brighter.
Thank you, Your Highness. But I fear I may be intruding. You see, I was not invited as the Princess Crystal.
Oh, what's an invitation to someone as beautiful as you? You're welcome to remain as long as you wish. And now, may I ask you to dance?
You may, and I accept.
As you wish, Princess. We'll adjourn to the conservatory while members of the Royal Ballet entertain our guests.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, I regret to inform you that the Royal Ballet cannot be here tonight.
Oh.
I am delighted to announce that the principal players from the BBC, Luncheon Ballet Company, are here tonight.
Thank you.
served shortly in the Golden Hall. Would you kindly take your places?
I could have sworn Cinderella was my little daughter. The princess was my little daughter. But how could that be? Oh, I wish she could have been here tonight.
And to think, only this morning I thought I'd fallen in love.
In love? With whom?
With a young girl I met in the village during the hunt. She didn't know I was the prince, though. In fact, I led her to believe that I was Dandini, my own valet.
Wasn't that wrong of you?
Well, I suppose it was. But it was so nice to be liked for myself, not because I happened to be a prince.
And will you be seeing this girl again?
Oh, no. Not now I've met you.
I see. Prince Charming has a fickle heart.
Not anymore. I promise you.
Your Highness. No, I do beg your pardon.
Dandini, allow me to introduce you to the Princess Crystal. And I hope my future bride.
Your Highness.
You wanted me for something?
Yes, Your Highness. I came to tell you that the guests are assembled and the feast is about to begin.
Then we'd better come at once. Princess?
He soon changed his tune. From village girl to princess in one day. Oh well, prerogative of a prince, I suppose.
Now remember what I told you.
Oh, they've all gone.
I knew it. The moment our backs are turned, they'll dash off and start shoveling food down their gullies. Thanks to your let's go into the garden, they probably won't even get a bite to eat.
Girls, please. Remember, one of you is going to be the new princess, the first lady of the land.
You do mean me, of course, don't you?
Of course she does.
Eh?
I said, of course she thinks you ought to be the first lady of the land. So do I.
You do?
Well, why not? I mean, after all, you are the oldest one.
Why, you...
Euthanasia, hold your tongue.
But mind you don't bite it or you'll die of blood poisoning.
Please! Now, girls, I've just had the most marvellous idea. Asphyxia, wouldn't you like to do something with your sister?
Oh, don't tempt me.
I mean, why not do a double act?
What?
A combined effort. I don't suppose the prince has ever seen a combined effort before.
I don't know about combined effort, but she looks more like a combined harvester.
Oh, please.
Oh, there you are. Dinner's over.
For you all.
Yes.
Surprise? What surprise?
Something that will make you all very, very happy.
Yeah, she's going home and taking these two with her.
My two talented daughters will entertain for you.
Oh no.
Oh no.
I'm sorry, madam. The entertainment's all been laid on. Unfortunately, we don't have enough time.
Oh, it won't take a moment. Come along, quickly, girls. Show the prince your talent.
Sisters.
Sisters. There were never such devoted sisters.
Never had to have a chaperone.
I'm here to keep my eye on her. Caring,
sharing
every little thing that we're wearing.
When a certain gentleman arrived from Rome,
I wore the dress
and I stayed home.
All kinds of weather, we stick together, save in the rain or sun.
Who wrote this rubbish?
I don't know, dear. It was her idea.
Two different places, but inside places, we think and we act as one.
It gets worse.
It doesn't get any better.
Those who see us know that nothing can come between us.
Oh, really?
Is this slush or what?
Oi, I say, we've got to sing this or what?
Goodness sake, just get on with it.
Many men try to split us up, but no one can.
When was that then?
There was that blind chap. You know, the one from the sewage farm with the bad breath.
You never got close enough to smell his breath. He was too fast for you.
Oh, he was just shy.
Lord help the mister who comes between me and my sister. The Lord help the sister who comes between me and my man.
Oh! And now I think we just slip out and have a little refreshment before we do the encore.
And then, do something. Get rid of them.
Don't worry, Your Highness. Leave it to me.
It is her. I know it is.
Music, if you please.
My lords, ladies and gentlemen, I have just been informed that certain people have entered the castle without invitation slips.
Oh, shocking.
The footman will be around in just a moment. Would you please stay where you are?
Quick, go and get the others.
What is it? What's happening?
We've been spotted. Run for it.
I can't.
Neither can I.
You're going to have to, else we're done for.
Well, don't blame me.
Spencer, how can you?
Run for it. Stop them. Too late. They've gone. Now the party can really begin.
We've got a wolf again.
There's been no sign of the Princess Crystal at all, Your Highness. The guard saw no one but a young girl in a ragged dress.
But that's impossible. He must have seen the Princess.
Look what I found on the stairs, Your Highness.
Dandini! Her slipper! It must have fallen off as she ran. Take it. Search the land for the one whose foot it fits. Ladies and gentlemen, I swear before you that the person this glass slipper fits shall be my future bride. Now hurry, find her and bring her back to me.
I've never been so ashamed in my entire life. Chased out of a royal ball.
Just as I'd made a hit with the prince, too.
Who do you think you're kidding, fish face? The prince couldn't take his eyes off me all night.
I'm not surprised. That's the first time he's seen anything like you outside a zoo.
Oh, give over, you two. The only one the prince was interested in was that beautiful Princess Crystal.
Oh, yes. Wasn't she smashing?
Not half. Some folks have strange ideas of beauty, don't they? I thought she looked like an accident looking for something to happen.
She had so many wrinkles, she has to screw her hats on.
Well, we thought she looked smashing, didn't we, Thomas?
Yes, like a dream.
Yes. More like a nightmare, if you ask me.
You know, there was something very strange about her.
Yeah, there still is.
Fool! I meant the other one.
Oh, yes, I see what you mean.
I'm sure I've seen her somewhere before, that Princess Crystal.
How could that be, my dear? Sorry. Possible. Impossible.
After all,
how many princesses do you know?
She wasn't a princess when I knew her. She was... Oh, what was it? Let me think.
Well, if you ask me, she looked like a cleaned-up version of that little drip, Cinderella.
Nonsense. Out of the question.
No, that's it. Cinderella.
You out of your tiny mind? We left her at home doing the laundry, didn't we?
We thought we did. Quickly, back to the mansion.
But Medusa, my pet, she came in a big golden coach and a ball gown and slippers made of crystal. Now, when would Cinderella get anything like that?
I don't know, but I intend to find out. And if it's not a cleaned up version of that scruffy little ragamuffin of yours, then why are you looking so guilty? Mm. Now quickly, and if she's not there waiting...
But Medusa, wait!
Oh, we're all on our own!
With two legs!
Good idea,
yes! Oh, don't go! But the night's young and I'm so beautiful!
Come to a little passion flower.
I'm sorry. I can't stand passion flowers, you say that. I can't stand passion flowers. I get terrible hay fever.
Come back to my boudoir with me and let me show you my pièce de résistance. You what? Well, it's a big barber's pole fixed up over my fireplace.
What's that for? Something for the weekend?
Oh, you are awful! No! It's to remind me how many close shaves I've had.
Pity you didn't have one this morning. Your beard's showing through. Stick with me, kiddo, and I'll show you what a real woman's made
of.
It's a piece of cake.
Oh, thank you. Thank you, Daddy.
Cinders?
Yes?
Well, were you? Oh, never mind.
Never mind what?
Well, I thought I saw you at the ball tonight, but that's silly, isn't it?
Yes, it is.
Well, I bet you guess you better do what your grumpy earth, your stepmother says. Tidy up a bit. I'm going to go and get changed, and I'll come down and help you with the supper.
Poor Daddy. He's so kind to me. Oh, if only I could tell him the truth. Oh!
What's the matter with you?
Sly little cat.
Take that!
And that!
And that!
What have I done?
I'll tell you what you've done, you cross-eyed little toad. You look just like the princess. That's what you've done.
Ferret-faced little creep.
And why shouldn't I look like the princess?
Because you're nothing but a scruffy little kitchen maid, that's why.
And you haven't got any manners.
And you're uglier than she is.
And you're uglier than I... What do you mean she's uglier than I am?
Well, dear, it's one of the penalties of age, isn't it? You can't keep your looks forever, can you? I mean, look at you. You've got a face like a squeezed orange.
That's a lie. I've got the face of a saint.
Yes, Saint Bernard.
What are you sniggering at, big mouth?
Nothing.
Well, try nothing this one.
Guess what? Prince Charming and that Dan Daly fella have just arrived in the village again. They're looking for a woman.
Well, set them up. I'm waiting.
They said a woman, not a nervous breakdown.
They want buns.
I don't know, but I did hear that the prince fell in love with a beautiful woman at the ball tonight. Well, she ran away and left him. Nobody knows who she is, but she dropped a glass slipper on the stairs. And the prince says whoever it fits, he's going to marry her.
Marry her?
There it was, wasn't it? Oh.
My shoe! I found my shoe! I knew I'd dropped it somewhere.
What do you mean your shoe? It's my shoe, I tell you. I distinctly remember it falling off as we ran up the stairs.
That wasn't your shoe you dropped, ducky. That was your teeth. It's my shoe, I tell you.
It's mine, I tell you. Your shoes wouldn't fit. You had to wear the boxes. It's mine.
It's mine.
It's mine.
No, it isn't.
It's mine.
It is.
Oh, Buttons, it isn't true, is it?
Of course it is. I told you. I suppose it is your cinders, the glass slipper.
I remember it falling off as I ran.
So I suspect you'll be marrying the prince now then, won't you?
Oh, yes. Oh, Buttons, I'm so happy. I never dreamed that anything like this could happen to me.
I see.
fine clothes to wear and servants to help me. I can pay off all Daddy's debts. And then I'll... Buttons, what's the matter?
I'm going.
Oh. Come back! You can come to the castle with me! Oh, Buttons, come back! It hadn't been for you, I could have been the Princess Crystal.
So I was right. Cinderella was the princess after all. I must warn my daughters at once.
Cinderella! Cinderella, what's the matter?
Oh, Daddy, it's Buttons. He's gone away and left us. He thinks we won't be needing him any longer.
Nonsense. Of course we shall. Now, don't you mind. I'll go and fetch him back myself.
Mummy has a special treat for her own very favourite little stepdaughter, haven't you, Mumsy?
Come to Mummy, darling one. Hi.
This is something we want you to do for us, dearest.
So come along, be a good girl. No.
Stand still or I'll break your arm.
Turn at it, me.
Quickly, before the prince arrives.
Help!
Oh, it's no use screaming for help, princess.
Because nobody can hear you, princess.
And if anyone's going to marry the prince, we're going to make quite sure it isn't you.
Plenty of other girls would like to marry an intelligent, kind-hearted and witty fellow like me.
Yes.
Of course there is. Where? I can marry any... Over there. I can marry anybody I please, though I could. Trouble is I don't seem to please anyone. I'm just Buttons, I am. Common old Buttons.
Never wanted there's any work to be done. It's about as much use as a chocolate teapot. Anyway, why should I care about her marrying Prince Charming? Just you wait until she finds out you beat her twice a day. And locks you in the castle's dungeon so she can't have any friends. Just you wait. She'll come running back to me and she'll say, Buttons. That's right. She'll say, Buttons.
I need your help.
I need your help. And I'll say,
Houdini.
Oh, Marlon Brando again.
Houdini, you gotta go back to the mansion at once. Cinderella needs your help desperately.
She doesn't. She's got a moldy old prince now.
Houdini, you don't go back now. She ain't never going to marry the prince. A wicked stepmother and her two stepsisters. They locked up in an attic room. When a prince comes round, no Cinderella. Bada bing, bada boom, no princess.
Why should I care? It's me that loves her, not him. If he goes away without finding her, she might decide to marry me after all.
Houdini, thin back those huge lug holes of yours and listen to me. If you truly love Cinderella, you're going to hasten to her aid. You hold her happiness in your hands. If you're half the man I think you are, you're going to hurt yourself to make her eternally happy. Capiche?
Come on. I mean, well, you didn't want to ask me.
Right?
Oh, hang on, Cinders, I'm coming.
Now, Bobbini, you're so in love with Cinderella. Yet it's written in the stars that you gotta marry some other guy.
Oh,
I know, it's a shame. Still, by doing this, he's gonna prove to himself and to everybody else that he's no longer just a man anymore, but a good fellow. That's important. Would have been easy for me to set Cinderella free in time to try on the crystal slipper. But this way... I'm in complete agreement. This way, Houdini and Cinderella are going to be reunited as family again. Now let's go back to the mansion and see what happens.
Okay. Quickly, they're coming up the path.
I'll let them in.
Oh, dude, on your face to frighten them away.
was sick.
I say, what are you doing with my slipper?
Your slipper?
Ignore her, darling. It's quite obvious that such a dainty little slipper belongs to me.
Perhaps we should settle the argument by letting her try it on.
Oh, she's always trying it on.
Listen, who's talking, the walking bear trap? Hand it over.
Not so fast, Madame Lamode. I'm first in line.
You certainly were when it came to handing mouths out.
I'll go and stick your head in a mincing machine. It might improve your looks.
Footman.
I know why they call him the footman.
Really?
It's because he's carrying the slipper.
Well, who's going to try it on first?
Me!
Asphyxia, I think. We'll wait till last.
I'll sit on this chair.
I should be careful. They only support up to half a ton.
Where's that slipper? Push! Push! Ow!
I'm afraid your foot's too large, madam.
Rubbish! It's the slipper that's too small. Fetch me a larger one.
I'm afraid it's this one or nothing.
Wait, I'll take my sock off. Again.
Ow! It's quite obvious that the slipper is not going to fit. Let the other one try now.
Come on, move over, that ugly bug. Make way for the future princess. It fits! It fits!
What? What are you going to do?
Hey, alright, wait a second. Where's the glass? You're not.
Crikey.
Bring out the crowd! Start writing the invitation!
Oh, my fresh!
Come on, then!
Wait a minute, wait a minute! Something fishy going on here!
Now let's try the sticker on your wheel, sir.
Oh, bloody well. Wait, wait, there's something stopping my foot from going right in.
Yes, they're called toes.
Don't worry, precious. Mummy will fix this.
Oh, come down, Dini.
Quickly, darling, hold down your foot. No, it's the old rock cord. It will only hurt for a minute.
Get away from me.
Tried the slipper on everyone in the land, and it seems to fit no one. Our search is hopeless. We may as well return to the castle.
One moment, Your Highness. Didn't you once say you were under the impression the Baron Harlot had three daughters?
Of course. The girl in the woods. Oh, Dandini! Could it be possible that it was her? Yes? Don't you have three daughters?
Three daughters?
A girl!
Only one?
Me!
These two.
Hey, stop! Wait!
Cinderella!
Cinderella! I thought you said there are no other daughters.
There are! She's just a kitchen maid.
No, she isn't, is she, Funk?
Yes, she is. Oh, yes, she is. No, she isn't.
This is Baron Hardup's real daughter, Cinderella.
Dandini, it is her. I know it is.
We'll soon know when she tries to slip on. Come, Cinderella. There's nothing to be afraid of.
Oh, no, he keeps it. You're going to fit her. The slipper!
It shattered into a thousand pieces!
How unfortunate!
Poor thing!
Now she won't be able to try it on!
But it was Cinderella!
Cinderella's slipper it was.
But how can we be sure? Wait!
Where's she off to?
She'll never join that together with you, Hoof.
She's coming back! Look, here's the other slipper.
It's identical. And it fits. My search is over. Cinderella, I claim you as my bride.
What's going on here then?
Cinderella's going to marry the prince, and we're going to be punished for all the nasty things we've done.
Jolly well serves them right, doesn't it?
Yeah. Don't cry, Mother.
What did you say?
I said, don't cry, Mother. I'll gladly forgive you everything you did, for how can I bear to see someone so unhappy when I'm so wonderfully happy myself?
Oh, Cinderella!
And as for buttons, you shall have your own penthouse at the castle, and anything you want will be yours for the asking.
How wicked!
What about these two?
What are we going to do about them?
Oh, mercy, mercy!
We were only so nasty because we were so jealous of you.
You're so beautiful. We're so ugly. We thought we'd never get married if the boys saw you first.
We're so sorry. Please forgive us.
Of course I forgive you.
Please don't have us executed.
Or thrown into jail.
I forgive you.
Please don't banish us.
Or send us to Centre Box.
We had it the first time, dear. Just this our last chance to pick up an award for Best Supporting Actress.
So everything's worked out all right, and my little Cinderella will no longer be the daughter of a poor baron, but the wife of Prince Charming.
And just to show you how sorry we are, I and my two daughters will write out all the wedding invitations.
Splendid!
All right. But before we start, we have a little invitation of our own to send out. Haven't we, Uthie?
You mean,
Excuse us,
Yeah, we've got to repossess some furniture from number 10.
Nursery furniture.
Wait! Come back!
Come back!
Tally-ho!
So, Cinderella, your prince has found you at last, and I grant you both the gift of eternal happiness. The broken slipper will be restored to you, and from this day forward, your love will pass into legend, and your names be remembered forever.
Nothing's impossible, I have found, for when my chin is on the ground, I pick myself up, dust myself off, start all over.
Grateful for a pleasant trip, and pick yourself up, dust yourself off, and start all over again. Work like a soul inspired, till the battle of the day is won. You may be sick and tired, but you'll be a man, my son. Don't you remember those famous men?
tell me this, sir. What are we doing out here whilst everyone else is getting changed for the wedding?
Someone's got to win paint these decent people.
So do the elephant gag now.
We can say if we can. Yeah, I know.
Thank you. Yeah, I thought you might.
What is it?
The silly song.
Look, we'll all be enjoying that. Cool.
The silly song.
Well, easy. It's your idea.
It's the silly song. Let's get on with it. I want to see Cinder in a lovely dress.
Why am I confused, huh?
What are you on about?
You know, Cinder's seeing you in a lovely dress.
Oh, you're as thick as he looks, you are. Let's just get on with the song. Ladies and gentlemen, the song.
In the key of chub, please, Ian.
Who has 59? get him out there, shall I?
Something for everyone that comes to mind.